Hello and welcome to this lecture on radio. Today we will talk about characteristics of this medium. Radio is one of the most important tools of mass communications. It is a result of several innovations and discoveries by various scientists across the globe. Many of the important developments in the radio technology happened in the last few years of 19th century. The trend continued in early 20th century, and it slowly became a popular medium for mass communications. In this lesson, we will mainly talk about the characteristics of radio. We will discuss the features of radio that distinguish it from other media and give it its own unique position amidst various other communication media. Present-day mass communication scenario is populated by various media like print, television, theater, cinema, internet, mobile phone, etc. In this competitive environment, each medium stands out for its own unique qualities and abilities. We will discuss these qualities in the context of radio in order to understand it as a communication medium. Let us start with understanding the elements that form any radio program. The characteristics of these elements also help to shape the identity of radio medium. In our day-to-day interpersonal communications, we rely heavily on verbal communication. We talk and we use language to communicate with people around us. We also communicate with the use of gestures and body language. So, these are some elements of communication at the interpersonal level. Similarly, the print medium uses printed word, photographs, illustrations, elements of design for communication. The radio content is made up of four main elements. These are voice, music, sound effects, and silence. Voice is probably heard most of the time. Voice, or the spoken language that we hear on radio most of the times, conveys most of the content and meaning to us.
So, tell me, what's your name? What's your weekend?
The language used here is slightly different from the written language used in print. The radio scripts are meant to be spoken out, so they are written in a more conversational manner. In fact, use of small and simple sentences and simple vocabulary is a main characteristics of radio language. Music provides a mood. A background to the radio program. It helps to provide entertainment as well. Sound effects help to create a visual around the words narrated to us by the voice. They add a feeling of reality to the content being presented in radio. Silences are not heard for very long. In fact, a prolonged silence might give an impression of a break or malfunction in broadcast. But little pauses help to form the grammar of radio. Certain characteristics of radio are basically because of its technical makeup. These have come out of its technical properties and limitations. We will start with talking about these properties first. Most important and probably most obvious feature of radio is that it is an audio medium. Radio is sound. It is a medium based on audio only. All the elements that go into making of radio program are different kinds of audio. Because it's an audio medium, it engages only one sense of the listener. It is a single sense medium. When one listens to the radio, only the ears are engaged. So one could be doing something else and still be listening to radio. Unlike in newspaper or television, the audience does not have to suspend all other activity to engage with the medium. This may be perceived as a drawback and also as a strength. It is strength because radio can get more audience. It does not demand undivided attention. So audience could be driving, cooking, jogging, eating and still be listening to radio. They don't need to sit down and dedicate themselves to this activity at a particular point in time. In fact, a lot of people listen to radio only when they are driving. But this characteristic could also be seen as a disadvantage because the audience is very likely to get more engaged in other activities and pay less attention to radio broadcast, which means that the radio content would not leave the desired impact on the audience and it would only play in the background. Though, sometimes we do need some medium to just be present in the background. as audience, we all know that we do not always want to engage most actively with a medium. A background medium in itself is a break from other more demanding media. The radio content exists in time. The listener has to experience it right when it is on air. He does not have the option to access his choice of content at will. The nature of radio is such. In other words, radio is transient in nature. It is different from a medium like, let's say, printed newspaper, in which one could probably read the headlines in the morning and go through the details sometime later. In fact, if you fail to understand something that has been said or explained during a broadcast, there is no way of going back to it for reference. Unless, of course, if the radio station schedules a repeat telecast. So, radio cannot be referred back to. One has to listen to it and understand it as and when it is on air. This imposes certain checks on the kind of language that is spoken on radio. It is better to not to use difficult words which are difficult to pronounce or not used by a large number of audience. Similarly, use of simple and short sentences delivered at a moderate pace makes it easier for the audience to follow it. An unfamiliar word or a complex sentence will leave the audience perplexed. They might want to go through it again, but that would not be possible. If they refer to some other source to understand it, they will miss out on the ongoing broadcast. We will discuss the language-related properties of radio in further detail after a short while. Radio is known for bringing the content in the fastest possible manner. It has tremendous speed. This is largely due to the fact that radio operations are much simpler than those of television and newspaper. In fact, radio works best in the live situation because of the simple techniques involved. The reports from remote areas, scores of cricket matches played overseas, results of an award ceremony, or excitement of an ongoing concert, all can be shared live and immediately with the audience. It makes radio one of the fastest and most exciting medium. Even audience responses or questions can be shared and addressed at a faster pace. Though in the last few years, television technology has also been able to provide similar paced and fast delivery of information to the audience, the radio scores because of its relative simplicity and low costs. In fact, low costs are one important feature of radio. The cost of setting up a radio station is not very high. Similarly, production of radio program is a relatively simple and low-cost process. You do not need camera, lights, and lots of people to handle them. Unlike print media, there is no need to make multiple copies of the finished product. The receiver can also be bought at a very, very low cost, and the audience can listen to the content without paying any subscription fee or any kind of membership. This makes radio one of the most low-cost medium and also a very suitable medium for various operations and communication requirements where huge amounts cannot be spent. Another feature of radio is portability. Radio sets have become smaller and smaller in size. They were portable and carried around in bags slung from shoulders even a few decades ago. Then they became smaller and fitted into our pockets. Now they have got squeezed into our palms and have become so small that they are also sold as part of various other gadgets. Nowadays, you could easily find a radio of the size of a matchbox, and it is not rare to find a radio set fitted within the body of a mobile phone or headphone or even a toy. The radio broadcast knows no boundaries. Books, magazines and films can be blocked at boundaries of states and nations and institutions. But radio cannot be stopped in this manner. One can't really place a firewall or administrator to restrict its content. This boundless power can be used to send messages of enlightenment and joy to people across the border. One good example is Radio Ceylon, which became very popular with listeners in India as it was able to provide them their choice of entertainment. Though many a times, this power of radio is also used for spreading rumors, propaganda and hatred. There is one more feature that emerges out of understanding all these properties of radio. Radio, in fact, is a very simple medium. The equipment involved in making a radio program is very simple to operate. One person with a tape recorder is a complete outdoor crew for radio. You need no cameras, lights, etc. to record for radio from the location. Radio content once ready does not have to go through complex and time-consuming process of duplication. There is no need to produce several copies like in print media. It is ready for broadcast and sharing with masses as soon as its content is finalized. Now, let us discuss some characteristics of radio which are largely related to the language used in this medium. Radio is a spoken medium. The language that is used has to be different from the written language used in print media. As we said earlier, that short and simple sentences are to be used. While selecting words, one has to avoid jargon, slang and tongue twisters. And the language has to have the quality of being conversational. That makes it slightly informal, but still free from colloquial usages. Let us not forget that radio is reaching to a vast audience spread over a huge geographical area. Many of these people might not be illiterate. Radio might be their only source of information and connection with the outside world. So, we have to keep a heterogeneous audience in mind. The informality of the spoken language builds an easy connect with audience. But slang of one locality might be completely lost on the audience of another area. So, we stick to the simpler version of widely spoken language. Mixing the tongues can also be a problem. We might imagine that we are trying to make it more accessible to the audience, but we actually end up distancing ourselves from all those people who don't know any of the two languages. Though radio is an audio medium, it is known for its ability to build images. We could say that the language of radio helps us to create visuals in our mind. In fact, it is our own natural tendency to attempt to visualize what we hear. We would try to think of the image of the person speaking to us from the radio. Properly scripted content of radio is going to further assist us create these visuals with the mind's eye. These visuals can be varied. We will always try and visualize a scene in the auditorium where a state function is happening, or that in a stadium from where a match is being broadcast live. Appropriate commentary will help us to organize our thought and visualize something close to what exists at the scene of broadcast. In the process, the audience also gets more involved in the listening. What is interesting and what probably makes radio a powerful medium is that, unlike a visual medium, the visuals here are not limited by the size of the screen. If supported by appropriate sound effects and right music, virtually any situation from a space age war to medieval king's darbar can be created in the listener's mind. And you do not have to spend a penny on sets, art direction, special effects and lighting. The radio cannot accommodate a huge amount of content. In fact, it has very limited space. Of course, we cannot forget that radio exists in time. That is why it is a transient medium. When we say that radio lacks space, we imply that its ability as a medium to hold or convey content is quite limited. Let us understand it with this example. On radio, typically 120 words are spoken per minute. So, a limited amount of content per minute, a 10-minute bulletin would carry words equal to those in two columns news. So, the news or any other content would have to be presented in brief. After all, you have a limited number of minutes in a day. On the other hand, there is practically no limit to the number of pages that can go in a magazine or a newspaper. This allows them more space and more flexibility. Radio has to, however, present its content within these space constraints. This could be seen as a disadvantage of radio. It is important to understand this feature in order to make better program for radio. Though a radio broadcaster speaks to tens of thousands of people at the same time, he does not treat them as a group. In fact, for the radio listener, the experience is of being addressed personally. That is why radio is more personal. Broadcaster speaks in a manner as if he was speaking to a single person. The radio broadcast does not speak to a group, rather he speaks to the individual. This makes the listening experience personal for each individual member of the audience. The radio connects with audience in the present and the communication style is one-to-one. That is why the broadcaster does not use the radio as a huge public address system. The broadcaster actually speaks to one person. The radio is selective in presenting the content to the listener. Radio content has to be presented in a linear order. This order is decided by the people in the radio station according to what they think would be liked by most of the audience. This lack of space that we earlier talked about also compels these people to limit the content and to include certain things only. So, when the content reaches us, it has gone through an extensive process of selection and ordering. The transient nature of radio makes it necessary to choose an order, and it is not possible for the listener to upset this order for their own preferences. Compare this with the newspaper, where you can read the content in an order that you like. The reader may start with the horoscope and then go to the sports page and have a look at the editorial before reading the front page. He may also glance through the headlines, pictures and bits of news once and then read the news in detail when more time is available. The technical qualities of radio have helped us to formulate a certain grammar for its language. These properties of the radio are important characteristics of radio. These characteristics that I have been talking about also ensure that radio reaches a large number of people. It is a low-cost medium. It is easy for even a poor person to own a radio set. He does not have to pay anybody to receive the content. It is free to air, though he might have to spend a little on the batteries. The receiver set is portable, and that makes it very easy to carry it around and listen to. One is not tied by any cords or cables. And radio broadcast reaches almost 98% of India's territory. All these factors ensure a higher reach of radio amongst the audience. In fact, higher reach can be counted as another characteristic of radio. In these characteristics and the resultant higher reach also make radio more suitable for certain purposes. One characteristic of radio is that it is very suitable for aid in distance education. It is not viable to spend much on educational programming, especially when the size of audience, in this case, all students enrolled in a particular course, is not very high. Suppose a very specialized program of an open university attracts 40 learners. If these learners are spread in different parts of India, then reaching out to them through other medium would be very costly. TV airtime is costly, and in this case, you will either need one national broadcaster or several regional or local channels. The cost of printing per copy comes down when you do large-scale printing. Printing or copying a limited number of documents proves to be very costly. But radio does not have these limitations. That is why radio becomes an important part of distance learning programs, and it also becomes a default choice in this kind of a situation. Producing and telecasting an educational program on radio is viable even when the number of students is small and they are spread over a huge area. Radio is actually a perfect medium to reach out to a small and stratified audience because of its low cost and huge coverage area. This very virtue also makes it a suitable medium for public service advertising. Though such advertising is extremely important for society, it does not lead to immediate returns. In fact, the returns accrue to the society in long run in the form of a better living environment. But unlike commercial advertising, it does not aim to justify itself through revenues. So, the purse strings for this category of advertising are always held tight. The lower costs in production and broadcast make radio a preferred medium for public service advertising. Its wider reach and the fact that the target audience does not have to be literate to understand the message makes it even more suitable. These were some of the main characteristics of radio. Radio is an important medium of mass communications, and it is a completely audio medium. Its technical makeup gives it certain features, while some features are based on kind of language that is usually spoken on radio. These language-related features may also be seen as certain conventions which have evolved out of decades of attempt to make radio communication more effective and enjoyable. These conventions are practiced widely. Some features have emerged out of technical, economic, and language features, and it has become more suitable for certain requirements. Thank you so much for watching this program. Hope you enjoyed this lesson and found it useful.